they did give him security clearance that he had, but they also, you know, showed him the door at a certain point, too, because they weren't satisfied with his service. So there's certainly been quite a lot of tweeting happening. I think Trump opened, the president opened the day tweeting about how members of the panel should be asking Yates about whether, intimating that she could have been the source of those leaks. And of course, she did get some of those questions from members of the panel. And then he was just tweeting a few minutes ago saying that, you know, the fake news media must be upset because Yates didn't say anything new. And it's true that Yates didn't necessarily, you know, open an entirely new can of worms or point the finger at any other member of the Trump administration directly. But she did give these additional details about exactly how much urgency there was behind her concerns and how often she was in touch with the White House counsel about expressing that urgency in fairly short order. I mean, the timeline of these meetings, two phone calls, two in-person meetings, all happened within 4 days, from January 26th to January 30th, as she was describing. And then, of course, her knowledge of what then happened in the next 18 days goes cold because she was shown the door herself from the administration.